Hi friends, this is Harinaganand Idumudi. If you want to get more updates, please subscribe our channel. Our channel name is Short and Hub. If you want to join in my WhatsApp group, please send a message to 9704455002 informing your state and name, etc. Our channel has been providing both general and legal dictations ranging from 60 words to 200 words per minute, along with advanced outlines for all examinations which are conducted by the Staff Selection Commission, court including High Court and Supreme Court, RRB and other state and central government examinations to improve speed in stenography. Further, our channel has been providing dictations on current affairs which never dictated on any YouTube channel. Important links are available in the description box. Get ready for the passage at 100 words per minute. 5 seconds left. Start. My dear fellow citizens, I am very happy to come over here and share some of my thoughts with you on this important occasion. A birth anniversary is a day of rejoicing, whether it is an individual or of a nation. All of us celebrate it in big cities as well as in small towns. On this day, I am inclined to think of our struggle for independence and remember those great leaders who have sacrificed everything for the sake of the country. It is our good fortune that a few of them are still with us. We have to honor them and try to learn lessons from their sacrifices. I feel that this is not the occasion to talk at length about our achievements and all that we have done to raise the standard of living of the common people. In any case, the record is there for everyone to see. Not only the people of India, but also the people of other countries know about it. We are all reading in newspapers as to how the leaders of other countries have been talking about it. That doesn't mean that we have achieved our task. It doesn't also mean that we have fulfilled the hopes and aspirations of our people. It can only mean that we are on the path shown to us by our great leaders. If we march ahead on the same path despite the difficulties and dangers, I have no doubt whatsoever that we will achieve our goal. In several parts of the country, there are agitations and people are making all sorts of demands. In a democratic country, it is quite natural for the people to express their views peacefully. Our only concern is that it shouldn't lead to violence. We are always prepared to talk to the people and also meet their demands to the extent possible. At the same time, we have to be careful that we do not hurt the feelings of others. It is therefore necessary to discuss the demands with all those who are concerned and taking into consideration their interests also. Here, I would like to draw the attention of the people to the fact that violence is harmful to the country as it obstructs the process of development. Today, the country is facing many dangers. There are external dangers and internal weaknesses also. I do not want to scare you by saying this. I am sure we will be able to recognize the situation and keep ourselves fully prepared to face it. Though there is no direct threat to our borders at this time, there is an atmosphere of war throughout the world. It is a well-known fact that we in India always cherish peace. We want friendship with all our neighbors. I would like to state categorically that we do not want to interfere in the internal affairs of any country. We are of the firm opinion that the countries must resolve their internal problems by themselves. But if there is large-scale violence, we have to condemn it, and we have also been doing so. We must deal with all these problems in the most responsible manner. First of all, we must try to understand the problem and then take steps with great care. It is only in this way we can succeed in our efforts.